Hi, this is Dr. Michael Ruscio, and you've likely heard of this recent study that found no correlation between serotonin levels and depression. However, we should also provide some juxtaposition to this finding and look at what impact exercise has on depression. And I'd like to share with you here a 2019 systematic review with meta-analysis looking at aerobic training. Now, this is not to say that aerobic training is the best form of training. It's just to provide one data point looking at one type of exercise. Aerobic training for 45 minutes, three times per week for 2 months had a large effect size on depression. Effect size is the magnitude of benefit. There are some interventions that may document a statistically significant outcome, but it may not be clinically meaningful. The effect size is what helps us delineate that. So in this case, the large effect size means there was a large impact on depression and what may be happening. How is it that exercise may be improving depression? Well, as a quick aside here, we know that when we track with repeat microbiota or gut bacterial community tests, the health of the gut microbiota over time in sedentary individuals who then start exercising, we see positive shifts in their gut bacteria. We also know that exercise is anti-inflammatory, that exercise increases BDN or BDNF, brain-derived neurotrophic factor, which literally helps the brain fuse better connections between neurons. We know that exercise improves circulation. We also know that some people who exercise will be doing so in nature, and that there is a direct therapeutic effect on both mood and energy levels from time in nature. There are endocrine effects, like transient increases in things like growth hormone and testosterone. And again, I want to be careful there because these effects are short-lived and don't appear to have a appreciable impact on, let's say, your total daily growth hormone or testosterone output, but perhaps these short perturbations in hormones are part of why exercise improves mood. And then finally, and not an exhaustive list here, but exercise will help deplete acetylcholine and help with sleep. So exercise is something that I think we should be considering first before potentially using a medication.